Right, here we are. I'm back up by Pontywaun Bridge again. I was looking at the barriers last time, 26 inches wide and 5 foot high on the metal barriers, and this goes all the way down to virtually 14 locks. So I seen a gentleman coming up now called Di, and I'm going to ask him a few questions and see what he got to think about it. Right then. Hiya Di, thanks for taking part in this today. It's going on Risca past and present. I've had a look at these barriers. They're 5 foot high and about 26-27 inch wide, and you're on an electric scooter which will get through it. But what's your views on these barriers anyway, from you to Rogerstone?
Well, that's what I can say, you're right for me here. But I see no problem at all.
Because they say it's like to do a motorbike.
Unless you have a larger scooter, which you can get now.
Right, so there'll be a bit of struggle. Yeah. And so this is 26 inches wide. If I look at Di's scooter, he can get through.
It's 2 foot wide.
So you've got a 2 foot wide scooter there. So obviously, there's a couple more photographers coming. Let them pass a second. So, right. So obviously I'm talking to Di here, sunny day, first sunny day. I've been out all morning, taking a couple of shots, and we're looking at the barriers, because there's a bit of a discussion on it regarding is to keep the kids off motorbikes running up them the canal, and horses running up them the canal. But the only concern I had was like the wider buggies, wheelchairs and pushchairs, the wider stuff. But Di thinks he's all okay, and how far do you get on it, Di, on a battery anyway, on a charge?
I get about 15
miles
this one.
So about 15 miles. So there we go. So you're happy at the moment having these barriers. You're all right with that scooter. But do you think it'd be a struggle then if I had a bigger scooter?
Oh, yeah. Well, just a lot of bigger ones now. We can get them.
Just one way to do it. Yeah.
The bigger wheels and
all that. Yeah. Do you think any changes should be made, or do you think it's for people like yourself on the scooters it's okay?
Yeah, I think it's all the ones I've seen around here anyway, no problem.
Right. All right then, Dad, brilliant. Thank you very much for that anyway. All the best. Take care.
You've got a pay to go through now, have you?
Right. Yeah, it's 50 pence now. I've got to get some funds in for the council. A little bit of sarcasm, isn't it? Mm-hmm. But all the best. There's another gentleman. Can I ask you a question?
What's that?
I'm filming this for Risca Past and Present.
Right.
I've been doing like a documentary.
Yeah.
And I've also done a lot of photographs for the page.
Yeah.
For the community of Risca and surrounding areas. What do you think of the barriers? Obviously, they say to stop horses. Stop horses, stop kids on motorbikes in the night messing up.
They don't stop horses, don't they?
They don't. What's your views on it? Because I measure.
Well, I've seen one or two horses here at night.
Right, I measured these a couple of weeks ago and filmed it for the Risca page, and they're 5 foot high and 26 or 27 inches wide. So I suppose.
Unless that one's open, like it might have been open, I don't know.
Right. Mm. But in general, do you think they should be a bit wider for, like, I was thinking of people with pushchairs, buggies in the south, people bringing family from away will come and stay in the community, they'll take them for a walk along the canal, and then the barrier could be a little bit too tight for certain scooters.
I don't know. Like, I've never had any course, like, I've never had anything to take through, like, you know?
Right.
You know, I've never had any pushchairs, but it's all right for pushchairs or prams, isn't it?
So if I said to you...
A lot of bikes go down. A
lot of bikes. Yeah. What do you think? Because some people say to try and keep horses and kids off motorbikes on you. So the discussion is, you know, my concern was people with the wider buggies, the wider disability buggies.
I haven't seen any.
Hmm?
I haven't noticed anybody. I got a friend with a buggy, like,
yeah.
And he can get through it.
But you don't find it's a struggle, well, obviously, with a stick.
One, so
it's okay.
I can't really comment, but I haven't noticed anybody complaining about it. Really.
Right. Mm. All right, and what was your first name?
Ron Johnston, yeah.
Ron Johnston. Thank you very much, Ron.
I'm a local. I was born in Pontywaun.
Yeah.
I lived in that house facing the bridge till I was 21. A big house.
Yeah.
And I live in Cumcan.
So it's a nice state today.
Yeah.
Ron, if we were making any changes to the community, like Risca and Crosskeys and Pontywaun, if there was funds now in the area, a lump sum of money, what do you think the money would be best redirected for and why, if we had a lump sum of money?
Increasing
our pension, yes. That's number one on the list.
No.
But in general, is there anything you think You think the community would need if you've been here for many years?
Yeah, I'm not one of these people who actually grind the roads, just need a bit of
so the roads, controls. Right.
I notice as a driver, like, you
know, right, for the potholes and stuff,
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, but down here I thought this kept pretty good, really.
Yeah. Oh, right, then, right. Yeah. That's superb. Anything else, or is that?
Not really, no.
Right, but the pensions. Oh, no. Yeah, we're going to double up on the pensions for the hard workers, yeah? And bring the pension up to the working age to 60.
I don't get a problem with the bins.
With the bins? Right, well, on time or over full?
I had a big bin, and I wasn't living here. I lost my wife and I was living in it with a lady friend at the time, but I kept my place going.
Right.
And my neighbour said he'd had gone into the lorry, the van, like, and she said, you go in, see, you go in. I said, no, but it was there before they turned up, and it was bloody gone after they gone, like.
Right.
So I didn't actually see it go in, like.
Right.
Like, oh, you got to buy a new one, like, you know.
Right, on the bins and that. Yeah.
They wouldn't do anything about it, like.
Okay then, Ron, that's superb. Thank you very much for your advice, anyway.
You work for the council, do you?
No, I'm just doing this locally to try and help the community, really, with photography.
Yeah.
So I've been out all morning, up around the bypass in Cross Keys,
yeah.
And the old green, and the old flying services, and I look at the old dairy, Cross Keys old milk dairy,
yeah.
And I'm working my way down the Risca now.
Oh, nice.
And I'll work my way back up later, up through Cross Keys. But thank you very much for that, anyway. Yeah. All the best. Take care, thank you very much. Ta-da. There we go. Everybody on news at 10, so. Now, I thought I'd get something from the community. I seen a guy, Dave, just came up on that scooter. I looked at a narrow one, I thought, is that going to get through a 26-inch wide barrier? And it did. And then I spoke to Ron then, he'd been here all his life. And he thinks to increase the pension, so I think a lot of people will agree with that. But it's over and out for now. Thanks for watching, I'll shut up. And I'll upload this later. Ta-ra. I've got a hard road to travel.